okay, just see this these numbers, and according to this I'm going to write my program. Let me just, okay, let it be there. Let me just give some space so that it is visible here. Okay, great, awesome. So what I'm going to do, I will loop through my old image. I'll see the values one by one, see where it lies in these blocks. This is my block number 0, block number 1, 2, 3, 4 and up to 7, where the numbers are lying, and accordingly I will put the pixels in my this new image which I have created corresponding, wherever I am getting a number in this image, in my old image, and that in that corresponding place of this new image which I have created, I will put what I am going to assign here. So suppose I get a number at, let's say, 3, 2 is 138. 138 lies between 128 to 159. So I'll put 4 at 3, 2 in this new matrix. So this will be my new image. So let me write it down. So I'll write the loop for I in range of image dot size is to get the size of image. Zeroth is the row number of, okay, and for j in range image dot size of I, sorry, one. Okay, so row and column, I'm going through each row and for each column, and then I'll check if the old images, which one, the pixel map, this is the old image which I have loaded in pixel map. So if pixel map, okay, of I comma j is greater than equal to 0, so I'm checking for the first block. If the number which I'm iterating through, okay, is greater than equal to 0, and okay, let me write this pixel map I comma j, and it is greater than 0 and it is less than equal to 31. It means this particular cell value lies between 0 to 31. If it is the case, then you write the pixel new i comma j as what you will put 0. Okay, let me just this, yeah, I'm going to use this line again and again. Let me just copy this. Okay, so I'll just put rather than if it is not in the first block, that value is not lying between 0 to 31. If it is lying between 32 to what, 63, then put what, 1. Copy this, because this is our else if part. I'll put here else if it is not even in the second block. So if it is lying between 64 to what, 95 is our third block, I'll put 2. Okay, and if it is not there, then if it is between 96 to 127 is my fourth block, so I'll put 3. Okay, and if it is not there but it is between 128 to 159. Then I'll put 4 there. Okay. And if it is between, if it is not there but in between 160 to 191, then I'll put 5 there. And if it is not there but in between 192 to 223, I'll put 6 there. And if it is not there, then at last, the last thing which I have to check is if it is between 224 to 255. It must be there. That's it. My work is done here. So I've created this new image. I have mapped all my blocks to my original, to whatever I wanted to, so that I can reduce the size. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, I'll just save this image with the command image.save. Let me write the name is lena_2.jpg. Okay, and I'll see the matrix also. So here I saw the matrix as, where did I write? Oh, I removed it. Oh, let me write it again. So J, let me write it at, write it at J, numpy dot as array, and image dot, I don't need to open it, I can just, I already opened it there, but it's okay. Lena let's go to dot jpg. So I will see this new image as an array and how it is looking. Okay, so my program is complete. Let me just run it. Great. So I've saved it. Let me just check this J. You can see all these values have been mapped accordingly. If you see, if you see this array, let me show you. 135 was where, 135 was lying between 128 to 159. Hence the 4 is written. So all these values, if you see, it is lying between 128 to 159. That's why I have mapped it with 4. So the mapping has been done, and I have saved the image as lena2.jpg. So I'll go to my folder and I'll see the image. You can see it. It's looking black, but it's not exactly black. So I'll open it, and you can see that some part, it's actually visible. The image is exactly same. If you look at the image here, you can see the image is exactly the same image. If you see the boundaries, if you see the face, eyes, and everything is same. It's just that we are trying to represent a 8-bit image into 3-bit image. That's why so much we have lost. We have lost a lot. It's looking, approximately everything is looking black, but still, you can see the image linings, all the edges, all the other things are exactly the same. So this is compression, and if you see the size of first image was 42 KB, this is just 4 KB, 4.86 KB. We've reduced a lot. Okay, so this is one type of compression which you can achieve through just this simple naive method. There are tons of method for image compression, and it is still a hot topic. People are still working on this compression technique. So if you see that these image formats, for example JPG, JPEG, these are all also compression techniques and how to represent an image in a very efficient way, so that it takes less time but the quality is not compromised. So this, we just wanted to give you a motivation of image compression and compression in general. That's why we showed this example. You can check out different algorithms for compression, and you can even discuss about that those algorithms in the discussion forum, so that we can we can give you inputs and or also we can learn about that. So this was just to motivate you guys how you can see how it is simple to see these things through the first principle and achieve such kind of things. So it looks like that compression is what exactly is going on with the compression. When we do the zip and RAR of some files, then we see that the size of file reduce and we just copy it or we just send it on email, but we don't understand what exactly is going on. So these simple methods are actually used in the background to compress those files. So image compression is a very hot topic, and there are very many ways through which you can compress the image. And actually people see the way study the way we perceive image, and based on those studies they do the compression, and it has been very successful venture through this. So please discuss about this technique in the discussion forum, and please ask question if you have any. Thank you.